Hey guys, I'm pretty sure I know how to get Warriors and Hero Streamstones, and it has to do with the sort of investigations we've been taking. So let's head over to the Resource Center, and I'll show you what I mean. Alright, well look at all these. I got a bunch of Tempered Elder Dragons. Let me tell you all the information that I want you to know, and then afterwards I'll ramble on with my opinions and everything else. So, it has to do with the conditions. The conditions are the faint, the max players, and the time limit. That's really what you want to be focusing on. If the faint is 2 or 1, if the time limit is 30 or 15, if the max players is 2 instead of 4, you're going to have a much better chance. If you have a combination of all these, you're going to have even a better chance. The boxes don't really matter unless these other conditions are met. If you have a 1 faint, max 2 players, time limit 15 with 4 boxes, 5 boxes, that's good. But if you have a faint 5 times with 50 minutes and it's got 5 boxes, it doesn't really matter. It's not going to really help. So let's talk about how to start this off. To even be able to participate in these quests, you have to have got so far in the story that you are HR 49, and then you get the Thunderous Rumble in the Highlands. It is a assigned quest, it's 9 stars, and it's how you are able to break the threshold and get past level 50 and up. It makes you eligible to even participate in these Tempered Elder Dragon quests. So, now that that's out of the way, your next question may be, how do I get these quests? Look how many you have. I have quite a few. You know, I wish I had more, but it's fine for now. How do I get these? Well, it's the Kirin. Everyone's running the Kirin. If you're SOSing Tempered Elder Dragons and you're thinking to yourself, how does everybody have these? What is it, just luck? Not really. Everyone's running the Kirin. He doesn't start the fight when you look at him. You can hang around with him all day. You don't have to bring the ghillie mantle. You don't have to really do anything. You just go on the quest and you follow him around. Let me tell you on average how many I get. If I walk for 15 minutes and I follow him around and I pick up all of his footsteps and everything else that he drops, I get around 10 to 30. 10 to 30 investigations. That's really just to put it into perspective for you guys. So that's not very many, because maybe 5 or so out of those, 5 to 10, will be good. And I'll tell you what everybody uses, and you can decide for yourself. I'll tell you what I think, and then you can decide for yourself. Everyone uses the Hunter's Headgear and the Hunter's Greaves. It's just Jagras parts to make them. It's not even great Jagras parts. Everyone runs Scholar and Scent Hound. Now see, Scholar speeds up the process on research levels and special investigations. And Scent Hound increases the gauge fill rate by 50%. I have ran this. I have followed the Kirin around with this on. It doesn't do anything. It's not worth doing. If you eat for researcher, if you have a voucher and you eat at the canteen for researcher, you can get some more research points, and that could be good, I guess. Like, that's like a why not kind of thing, but let me put that into perspective as well. I have done that as well, and after 50 minutes of collecting, and then after the researcher bonus, I have got like 1,000 something research points. Now if you look, I have 59,000 right now, so 1,000 is really like a drop in the well. It's not really a priority of mine. So if you're tough on vouchers, and you may want to save them for insurance, save them for specialist, save them for slugger. There are way more helpful things. And remember that after you're done farming all these footprints for the investigations, you have to either lose the quest, let time run out, or put a whooping on them. Because if you try to return from quest or abandon the quest, you won't get any of it. So you're thinking to yourself now, okay, that's great, but I don't have a Kieran, a tempered Kieran investigation, so this is, it's not helpful. Okay, well, this is going to be, if you're really at the beginning of this whole process, it's going to start with doing SOSs. You're going to have to SOS tempered Elder Dragons, and anytime that anyone breaks apart, it doesn't have to just be you, you have a small chance of getting an investigation. And then when you beat a monster up and it runs away to another room, it'll drop footprints, it'll drop other things that you could pick up for research points, and that can give you some investigations. And once you have a Kieran, you can run it, and then, you know, 10 to 30 investigations, you'd hope that you'd get another Kieran. You always just want one tempered Kieran. So ideally, the perfect quest would be that you could get from the Kieran would be a one feint. Max players 2, 15 minute tempered Elder Dragon with 4 or 5 boxes. And you would do that by yourself. You can't do, I mean, if you have a great plan and great DPS, you can go ahead and you can get your good friend, and you can make a plan and you can try to kill it, but 15 minutes is not enough for 2 people. Not typically. You're gonna need a lot more. So you're gonna wanna run it by yourself, because if you're by yourself, it has less health. If you're using an Elder Seal weapon, it's gonna take a whole lot less for the Elder Seal weapon to do what it needs to do, depending on what tempered Elder Dragon you're fighting. They all do different things. And that's gonna give you the best chance. Because if you're running a one feint, you can trust yourself to beat it. You know, besides a whole bunch of random people running around that you have to account for, you gotta watch everyone's moves. You can't even, you know, you gotta talk to them through stickers. So ideally that's what you want, but in reality, that's not how it's going to work. How it's going to work more likely than not is you're going to have to search for investigations, and I'll show you the best way to do that. Respond to SOS. You can try to do 9-star. 9-star is only going to be Elder Dragons, but I don't find a lot of luck doing this. It's going to be much more difficult doing it this way, because it just doesn't seem like it shows everything. And I know that sounds strange, but I feel like there's a lot more that it doesn't show you. So it's much better to go to high rank. And what you want to be focusing on is this little symbol. You see how this one is a sword? And this one is like a monster tied up. And this one is a monster head. You want to look for the swords. So you see how that one is purple down there? So I know that that's tempered, but I know it's not an Elder Dragon because it's not a sword. So I wouldn't even go to it. I would just back out twice, go back in. Okay, see the bottom one is a sword. Bam, Teostra, 30 minutes, faint 5 times. That's not really good, but what is important to know is that if you're going to be going this route and you're going to be fighting other people, the rest of the world, to try to get into these quests, you want some advantages, and looking for the swords is one of the best ones. See that one? That one is obviously not one. This one's one. 50 minutes, faint 3 times. So now that that's all over, and you basically have all the information for now that you need to get started on this, I want to tell you how I came to the conclusion. This is going to be the part where I ramble on my opinions on things. From HR 50 to HR 90, I wore Guild Cross Armor, because this was my mentality. You know, all of this is experimenting, and that's half the fun. I thought to myself, how am I going to get the best chance to get these augments, to get these Heroes and Warriors Streamstones? I thought to myself, well, Capture Pro, you can't capture Elder Dragons, so that's out. Carving Pro, you can't carve Warriors and Heroes Streamstones. So it's got to be, great luck is my best bet. And if I want to, if someone uses a meal voucher or I want to use a meal voucher, I'll eat for Lucky Cat. Well, I only ran Tempered Elder Dragons. And from HR 50 to HR 90, I got maybe 3 Warrior Streamstones. So the crummy ones. And I'm thinking to myself, what? You know, what is going on here? This, am I doing something wrong? This is the entire late game. How high am I supposed to go, you know? This is it. You know, you have that one friend and he says, oh, hey, you know, I have plenty of rank 8s. And you're just like, oh, yeah? Oh, no, you got them. You got them all? And they're all for your weapon too? No one believes that guy. No, it's not happening. So I thought to myself, something's got to change. I need something to really shorten what it could be, the variables, so I can experiment. So I took off the Great Luck because it's obviously doing absolutely nothing. And I said to myself, I'm only going to do one feint 15 minutes. I did some 2 feint. I did some 30 minutes, but it was always the handicap. I put the hard handicap on me. And from HR 90 to HR 100, I got around 20 Warrior Streamstones and a little more than 5 Hero Streamstones. Now, to put that into perspective, HR 90 to HR 100 is an average of 40 quests. It took me like 40 something quests. So if we're talking over, you know, 20 something streamstones in general, just, you know, warriors and heroes, if I got over 20 in 40 quests, that's me getting one half of the time, or more than half of the time, like 60%. And now let's take into account my entire late game, where I only got like 3 or 4 from 40 levels of doing almost the exact same thing. The only thing that I had changed was that I made sure that I stood with the one feint 15 minutes. That was my ideal when I was looking for stuff. It's the only thing that changed. There was no update to the game. Everything was the same. I only use the lance. How much could change, you know? I only use a certain set of items. Nothing changes. That's it. So for me, that was enough proof to say, okay, this is what I'm going to do from now on. And I brought all my friends into it. I said, hey guys, I think I'm onto something. Let's all start doing this. And guess what? Now we're all sending each other screenshots. Oh, what did I get? Oh, I don't use the hammer, but I got the Hero Streamstone for the hammer. Oh, what's this? What's that? You know? Oh, isn't that funny? Oh, how many did you get? I can show you a screenshot that I have 3 Warrior Streamstones in the rewards. And it went from 0 to 100. I'm getting nothing, and now I'm getting everything. So that's gotta be it. But this adds a whole new element to the game. And that is that, well, there's one feint, and there's 15 minutes. And if you're playing with people, 15 minutes means, well, you can't do it with 2 people. It's tough with 3 people, especially if you're doing randoms. You're gonna want 4 people. And if it's one feint, you're looking at everybody, you're thinking to yourself, how do I compose myself? You really have to focus. You really have to, it breathed new life into my end game, because now I have to be super conscious of what I'm doing and what everyone else is doing. And it's a great feeling, because when I got to HR 50 and I was able to augment my armor, the threshold off of it, And I was able to boost myself up. Now everyone I know, and you know, everyone that you're going to play with is going to have 450 to 500 plus defense. So, you know, it's a whole lot easier. You're not afraid anymore. Sure, people are better, but also their stuff is better. So you're thinking to yourself, okay, we might make some mistakes, but the monster's gonna die. It might be the strongest, you know, the end game monsters, but they'll die. Well, when you play like this, and it's a one feint, and it's 15 minutes, and you want to be careful, but you can't be too careful because you're against the clock, and no one can lose once. And you talk to everybody if it's organized, and you say, does anyone have feline insurance? Can we eat for feline insurance? It's a great feeling again, because now we're playing the game again. It's wonderful. I made a build for randoms. If you're going to be running SOS randoms, I made a build, and it's going to make it so that you guys survive exponentially. It's gonna improve the chances exponentially. It's gonna make it way easier to survive. I'm going to save that for another video because there's a lot that's going to be going into that as well. And I want to show you guys exactly what needs to be done and how to do it. And it involves the farm and everything else. So for right now, I just wanted to, this is the part where I'm just rambling on. I got everything out of the way. You guys have the information you need. Everyone can get their Hero Streamstones. We can finally start augmenting. You're gonna tell me that I'm level 100 and I can't augment my weapon? I can't augment. Everyone's running rarity 8s. I'm not worried about Warrior Streamstones. Anyway, so yeah, that's it. That's my piece for now. I appreciate you guys watching. I'm gonna work on that other video. And well, that's about it. Oh, wow!